Welcome back. Well, I have been very vocal about this and how important I think our arts and music and entertainment and how important they are for our youth, certainly in the Bay Area. And two organizations that are really making sure that this is continuing even in the middle of a pandemic are the University Area CDC and the Florida Orchestra. They have teamed up. They have been working on this program called Prodigy, and I'm so happy to welcome two guests this morning that can kind of help unpack this, talk about how important this is for our youth, and how they have changed this program to work virtually, like so many of us have. So Michelle Painter, violinist with the Florida Orchestra. We have Ron Bradford, who's in charge, one of the people in charge of the Prodigy program. So good to see both of you. We really appreciate your time this morning.
Thank you for having us. Happy to be with you.
Yes, good morning. Yeah.
So Ron, let's start with you. And if you could kind of, we've had a chance to kind of put a spotlight on this Prodigy program a couple times now. And I just love what you were doing with these students in the area. But remind everybody what the focus is and kind of what the motive is behind this program.
Yes, thank you for this opportunity. Well, the motive really is to transform young lives. And Prodigy has been doing this for 20 years. I can't believe how long it's been going on. And so how we do that, we do it by having visual and performing art classes. We hire instructors, they come in, they serve as mentors as well as teachers, and they have compassion, they have big commitment, they're very creative, and they reach the students. Through their teaching, they teach life skills, such as anger management, problem solving, communication, leadership, and goal setting skills. And what we found out is once the youth are equipped with these skills, they develop self-confidence and they're able to make an impact in their lives. And so we're so grateful to have the program continuing in its 20th year.
Well, 20th year, and now in 2020, things have never been more turned upside down. Talk about how you've been able to do this virtually now as well. I love this video that we're seeing. I think this tells the story of what so many families are going through. Have you been able to have the success rates, you know, doing it virtually as you had before?
Yes, that's a good question. So one important thing about our program is that we develop partnerships with several different agencies. We have Prodigy across West Central Florida counties. And so, of course, we've had to transition from having classes in actual classrooms to having classes virtually. And so what we found out is that the kids are still engaged, they're still learning, they still want to be in Prodigy, they're still learning the skills that we're trying to teach them, and they're still making an impact in their lives. And so the skills that we equip them with, they're able to have success. They're able to take the skills and go home in their neighborhoods, in the communities, and just shine like Prodigy is all about, having the youth shine.
So yeah, I love that. And of course, it's thanks to people like Michelle who are working with these youth as well. Michelle, tell me a little bit about your experience and what you've been able to do, you know, again, in these virtual times that we're living in.
Okay. Well, so basically I am the community engagement coordinator at the Florida Orchestra. So I kind of oversee all of the, you know, the activities of the instructors that work with our youth. And, you know, during this time, we've had to just adjust everything we do. You know, violin classes, it's a in-person thing. You know, it requires you to be right there with your students. So we were just like, what are we going to do? So we moved everything virtual online to Zoom, and we have our virtual classes. And our instructors, I have to tell you, they have had to get very creative to create a safe community, a safe musical community online and virtually for our kids. So it's really been incredibly, it's been wonderful, actually, I have to say.
So it's interesting because learning an instrument, and I remember this from when I was a kid, and I wanted to learn how to play the violin so bad. That is my all-time favorite instrument. And I got frustrated when I was a kid that I wasn't doing it right, and I just quit. I think that's so easy for kids to do when they get frustrated or feel like they can't do something, for them just to say, okay, I'm out. Have you guys had to deal with any of that? I'm saying, wait.
Yes, 100%. I think the sentiment that you just spoke about, it's even present in me as a professional, to be honest with you. And I think that's kind of what sets Prodigy apart. And that's sort of what sets our TFO Prodigy program apart. You know, that type of frustration, one thing that we really make sure that we integrate and we kind of drive home is how to work through those types of feelings and understanding, like, for example, if you do get frustrated with something, you're just like, okay, stop, think, work it out, commitments. You know, it's like these life skills that we teach to our kids, that is like sort of the centerpiece of what makes our program what it is. And that allows for our kids to shine. So when they are feeling frustrated, we try to give them the tools through art, through music, through violin playing to, you know, work through that issue and come out the other end. Because guess what? You're going to have to do that in life. You know, it's purely transferable for the rest of your life. So
2020 has taught us that more than ever. Yes. Can kids still sign up? Can youth? I mean, where can we go from here? We have probably about 30 seconds left, but if people want to find out more, if youth want to get involved, I mean, what would you have them do?
Go for it, Ron.
Ooh, fly. Okay, so what they have to do is they can go to our website. It's www.uacdc.org and you see Prodigy. So you go to programs and hit Prodigy Cultural Arts, and then you'll see the registration packet. You'll also see pictures of previous showcases our youth have had, and you can find out more information about Prodigy.
Thank you both for all you're doing in the community. It's never been needed more. Thank you for pushing through and figuring out a way to do it virtually. Keep us posted. We look forward to checking back in with you and your team.
Thank you so much.
We appreciate it.
All right, y'all take care. We, of course, will make sure and put more info on our website.